Happy Mercedesing! In our today's video, we're going to be answering, in fact, me, one comment I got concerning the airflow meter. If any of my videos helped you repair your car, then please hit the button super thanks. And if you, yeah, you, want to be the first one to watch my video as it is fully uploaded, then hit the button join. Thanks. Well, I think that you don't mind if I read my footage from my laptop computer. It's me who made the footage, of course. I read nothing, but I just don't like to have some, let's say it, like bad noises or bad talk, let's say it like that, like or to confuse myself. So now I'll be reading the text I planned for this video. The comment says, I did the initial CO adjustment like you described, but I don't have any play in the plate then. If I want to have a 1.9 mils play in the plate, I need to turn it four times counterclockwise. So I don't know what would be the right initial setup or if anything else is wrong. Currently, the motor don't start at all anymore. Okay. At first, if you have any starting issues, at first, you will have to deal with all four steps. Ignition, vacuum leaks, mechanics, and sensors. At the beginning, if your car won't even start because you turned the mixture screw too much counterclockwise, there is a possibility that your rubber hose connecting the ICV and the airflow meter fell off because of the detonation, which can happen when the mixture is too lean. So, at first check if that hose is on its place. Otherwise, you will never, and I repeat, never, be able to start your car. Let me show you what I mean. You see this part here. So here on M102 engines, here you have one port connecting the airflow meter and the ICV, and it goes like this. On M103 engines, this hole is here. So at first, check if that hose is on its place. At the very end, you have to deal with the mixture screw. And if you can't get the play, then don't try to get it at all, at any cost, because you will have to disassemble the whole airflow meter. Let me show you this. You will have to disassemble it. Look at it. On Ke-Jetronic, that's not some issue. But on KE, you will have to be dealing with many issues. You will have to clean the unit to remove the potentiometer, the shaft with these sliders, to remember the position of the sliders, because once you remove these two screws, this is going to fall like this. So if you did not remember the position of this of these sliders, then you will never be able to recalibrate the potentiometer again. What you else risk? You risk damaging the sliders, these two. If you can't get play in the airflow meter, that does not mean that your car don't run good. Concerning the initial mixture adjustment procedure. So let's remind ourselves what that means, the initial mixture adjustment screw is, and how it goes. Under those conditions, every car must start, and it says that you will have to bridge the fuel pump relay, and you turn the ignition on, you don't start the car. The fuel pump is going to be running constantly. Then you remove one of your metal hoses from the cylinders, each one of these. Let it be this one, for example. And now you start turning the key clockwise until you see that the gasoline is going to start flowing out of this port. Then it can be, who knows, half a turn, it can be one turn, a turn and a half, who knows, you're gonna see that. And then, as you see the fuel flowing from this port, then you turn the key here for half a turn counterclockwise. There. And under those conditions, each car must start. You must understand that the word initial does not mean ideal. It just means starting point from which you're going to be adjusting the mixture towards the nominal value. So if you know for sure that no one has been messing up with a screw in the past, just don't touch the screw. Replace the lambda and the potentiometer, and everything is going to be fine. Check the voltage on X11, which has to be fluctuating between 6.6 and 7.3 volts, and you're good to go. So, if you liked this video,
please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
Then, I would kindly ask you not to hit the button skip ad. That is going to help me a lot. And till some next one, happy Mercedesing. Bye.